Hey guys, welcome back to the Entertainment Lab. I'm back with another season recap, and this time I have season 1 recap of Narcos. Hope you like our video, and if you do, don't forget to hit the like button and do subscribe to our channel.
Yo soy Pablo Emilio Escobar Gaviria. Mis ojos están en todos lados, o sea, ustedes no pueden...
Season 1 chronicles the life of Pablo Escobar from late 1970s when he first began manufacturing cocaine to July 1992 when he escaped La Catedral prison. The show chronicles the main event that happened in Colombia during this period and Escobar's relationship with them. The show started at the year of 1973 in Chile with Mateo Cucarucha, a Chilean drug dealer and underground chemist in a secret cocaine lab in the Atacama Desert. Is discovered by the Chilean armed forces and his cartel members are completely executed, but Mateo surprisingly survives, in which later he managed to escape to Colombia. It is followed with the show how Escobar first became involved in cocaine trade in Colombia. He was an established black marketeer in Medellin, moving trucks worth of illegal goods into Colombia during a time when this is strictly forbidden.
Plata o plomo.
When introduced to Mateo, who pitched the idea that they go into business together, with Moreno producing and Escobar distributing a new profitable drug, cocaine. They expand Moreno's small cocaine processing lab by building additional large labs in rainforest and using the expertise of Carlos Leather transport their product in bulk to Miami, where it gains the interest among the rich and famous. With cocaine's growth into the drug of importance in American market, the Americans sent the task force from the DEA to Colombia to address the issue. Steve Murphy is partnered with Javier Peña. The role of Murphy's task force is to work with Colombian authorities to put an end to the flow of cocaine into the United States. At the time of Murphy's arrival in Colombia, Escobar and his associates are dealing with more significant problem than the DEA. They are at war with the M19, a revolutionary group of guerrilla communists. When the M19 kidnaps the Ochoa brothers' sister Martha, Escobar seizes the opportunity to form strategic alliance with other black marketeer criminals to establish a group called Death of Kidnappers, the genesis of Medellin cartel.
Prometo regresar a Marta Ochoa a su familia.
His promise to his allies is simple: to recover Marta Ochoa unharmed and to prevent further kidnappings. In the meantime, Escobar has politician aspirations as he desired to eventually become president of Colombia. He is elected as a congressman but is made a fool when a proof of Escobar having criminal ties to the blooming drugs industry is bought. Escobar plots his revenge. An extradition plan is passed in Colombia Congress, allowing the narcos to be extradited to the United States when caught. After making successive threats to Colombian government to repel the extradition plan, Escobar takes action against the Colombian Minister of Justice and a prominent lawyer of cartel members by gunning him down in his car. Murphy and Peña are finally making progress when they catch Escobar accountant Blackbeard along with a gigantic cache of incriminating evidence. The evidence is stored in the only place large enough and thought to have a security strong enough to thwart any break-in attempts: the Palace of Justice. However, Escobar hires the M19, his former enemies, to attack the palace and burns all evidence. The DEA is left with nothing after Escobar's slippery move.
In Colombia, Pablo Escobar made the whole court disappear.
Cesar Gaviria, the pro-extradition presidential candidate, is targeted by Escobar's assassin. Their plan is to blow him up while an Avianca Flight 203. He is saved when the DEA warns the president's team of the assassination plans.
In his unsuccessful attempt to assassinate presidential candidate Cesar Gaviria, Pablo Escobar murdered 107 innocent people.
The Colombian people are infuriated with the unmanageable level of violence, especially with the plane bombing. The DEA also manages to track down Jose Gonzalo Rodriguez Gacha, one of Escobar's principal associates, and violently gun him and his son Freddy down when they try to escape. As politician and his business associates begins to turn against him, Escobar finds a way to strike back at all. He kidnaps journalist Diana Turbay, the daughter of ex-president Julio Cesar Turbay. Escobar uses Diana as a politician bargaining chip to fight the extradition plans that the elected president Cesar Gaviria has set in motion, and also to negotiate a peace treaty between Medellin cartel and the government. After months of gridlock, the government makes a final attempt to capture Escobar, but government forces mistakenly clear hostage Diana Turbay. As Colombia mourns her death, President Gaviria accepts the terms of Escobar's deal, which allow Escobar to be incarcerated in his own prison, La Cathedral, which will be guarded by his own men. The deal also suspends the extradition plans. Escobar and his colleagues will turn themselves in, and tentative peace will be restored in Colombia. Nevertheless, Escobar suffers a tremendous personal blow when his cousin and the right-hand man Gustavo Gaviria is brutally killed by the search bloc. A designated team of Colombian special operation agents tasked with catching high-level drug barons. In the meantime, Escobar faces competition from the rival Cali cartel and opposition from members of his own crew. In La Cathedral, however, he is protected from authorities and can live in peace without constantly being chased by the search bloc. Escobar decorates La Cathedral to his liking and hosts guests frequently, including judges, prostitutes, and his family. The DEA managed to track the movement of the people going in and out of the La Cathedral and observe the two Pablo's closest associates, Gerardo Mocanda and Fernando Galeano, entered the prison but never left. As the rumors began to circulate that Escobar killed them in La Cathedral, the government uses this new information to try to convince Escobar to be transported in a jail in Bogota so the government can further fortify La Cathedral. Escobar does not approve to this, knowing that once in the government hands, he will be prosecuted and extradited to the US. The army nevertheless surrounds La Cathedral. Eduardo Sandoval, Vice Minister of Justice, decides to partially enter the prison to escort Escobar out. He mistakenly assumes he can Pablo's cooperative and is surprised when Escobar takes him hostage, forcing Sandoval to speak with President Gaviria on Escobar's behalf. President Gaviria, fed up with Escobar's persistent demands, calls for a special force team to be sent into the prison to kill Escobar and his men. The team enters and Sandoval is rescued safely, but Escobar narrowly escapes La Cathedral with a few of his men. Outside La Cathedral, Escobar is much more vulnerable because he has no longer has the protection of his 100 men. Thank you very much for watching this video, and if you like this video, please hit the like button, and for more such videos, please subscribe to our channel.